All right, what is up, guys? Welcome back to ArchiHacks. Today, we're gonna take this Rhino model and then put it into Google Earth, just like this. How is that even possible? One of the benefits of being able to place your models inside Google Earth is that your whole world is already modeled for you, and you can just right out of the box use it as your site model. And when you're, especially when you're rendering or doing a quick study, this can be super useful. There's no worry of having to like match your perspective or worry about how big your building is. And this can be like a really quick and handy tool, whether you're producing for your professor or for your boss, anyone. And yeah, this can be, and this is actually super quick, so I'm sure you'll love it. Let's dive right into it. So what you need is to download Google Earth, which is given out for free. Thank you, Google. And also your building, obviously. So first off, let's navigate to our building site. Today we're in Sydney and we found this like little rail yard site. It's a bit of a tangled circulation space, and I think this can be better used for residential or any kind of cultural space. So today's proposal will be some kind of twin tower building that is connected by a little bridge. All right, so first thing we have to do is to find an anchor point, kind of a bit of a reference point that is common to both Earth and our model. So for example, our building is in this shape, and I want our building to be placed right in here, kind of like in this triangle site. And in order to do that, I'm first going to make our plan completely north by clicking on the N sign here, then hit U, which allows our camera to be placed directly perpendicular to the ground, and then save our image by clicking Save Image button. And then again, disable all the signatures, and then click Save Image. The resolution doesn't really matter because we'll be removing it before importing it back. So we'll say satellite image, and then this takes a little while, and we'll go into our Rhino, go to plan view, and place our building by typing in picture command. Picture frame in Rhino 5, choose our satellite image. All right, let's drag and drop right into it, and then sort of try to match the image to your building. And one thing that's important is that we shouldn't choose like reorient this building, because this is oriented perfectly towards north and we want our building to reference to that instead of mixing that up. So in order to do that, I'm just gonna lock this image. So originally my model was oriented this way because it was easier to model that way, but once we have our true north referenced into our model, I'm gonna reorient it by simply using the rotate command. So I'll take this reference point, rotate it around, and something like that. All right, once our building is correctly oriented, I'm going to type in earth anchor point command and you have to make sure that all your geometries are selected, and then type that in. And what this command allows you to do is to find a point that we can reference back into the actual GPS coordinate. As you can see, we can type in latitude and longitude, and we're gonna get that from Google Earth. So let's go back to Google Earth, and in order to find out exactly what the longitude and latitude is, we're gonna use create a placement mark command by clicking on this yellow pin tool. And while this is active, we'll drag it to this bottom corner of this triangle site, and we can view our GPS coordinate. We can now copy this over and then place them into our Rhino. So I'll click on latitude and Control V to paste it. And for longitude, we'll also copy this value and paste it right in. One thing that you might have to be careful is that Google Earth sometimes give you a little space in front of the latitude or longitude, and this sometimes confuses Rhino. So make sure to omit that, or make sure to delete that before you copy and paste it in. And if you want to reference this again, you might want to save this so that we can bring it back or edit it later. So first I'm going to say, this is GPS location, and this is permanently saved to your places. And we can edit that again by right-clicking properties, and then we can drag that around. But for now, I'll cancel out. I think we have the correct values. Elevation can be left at zero because we can change it within Google Earth. So we'll say okay. And now we have to tell Rhino where this exact coordinate exists in our model. And for us, it's this bottom right corner. So I'll click here. And then after that, we have to define where the north is. And as we mentioned earlier, it'll be like perfectly in Y axis. So we'll drag our mouse up and then choose that. And last but not least, choose where the east is. And east is always on our right side, so I'll click that. And then for identification, we'll just skip by hitting enter or space. And then there we go. All right, our building is almost ready. One thing I might want to do is actually to add texture to the earth, the glass. Because Google Earth actually allows you to display really basic level of transparency or colors. And this can be pretty useful in making our presentation a little bit eye-friendly. So what we're going to do is I'm going to select these two layers, which represents the glass elements in my building, and then click on the Material tab. I'll rename this to glass and change this to custom material and change our color to something like dark blue, glossiness to 20%, transparency to 40%. And that looks about pretty good. Get preview. That looks pretty good. So we'll drag our entire model except our reference plane and then export it as a Google Earth file. Before you save it, make sure to drop down into the file type and find Google Earth, which is characterized by KMZ extension. And then let's name it as Earth Model, and we'll reference this back in Google. You can actually just drag and copy this. All right, when we're in Google Earth, we can hit File, Open, or Control O for short, and then type in our Google Earth file. And there we go. The file is already inside on a correct site at a correct location, perfectly aligned exactly where we want it to be. And you can take any kind of screenshot from here, and this will be like almost like 90% accurate. Yeah, and this can be useful for studying whether our building has impact on the skyline. As you can see, like we can confidently say that our building matches the existing skyline without disrupting the landmark building that's right next to it. And interesting narratives such as that is possible. And whether your building can be seen from the water or not, and yeah, that argument can be made almost scientifically. All right, that's enough for today. Thank you for tuning in. And if you're interested in supporting our channel, please consider getting one of our 3D people pack, which is super light, low poly people that are hand sculpted. Many hours are put into this and can be useful in any kind of circumstances. And I hope you guys will enjoy it. If you're interested in more niche tutorials like this, make sure to subscribe and ring that bell so that you don't miss anything. Special thanks to Kekitron, Michelangelo, Reese for your encouragement and technical support. They made this video.